Hello everyone, Jennifer Maker here. A new version of Cricut Design Space for Desktop, version 7.2, is starting to roll out, and there are several wonderful new features and important changes I want to show you, as they will change how you are using the software for the better. These changes also impact my tutorials, specifically the location of the Weld function, and I want to be sure you know where to find it. The big change in this version is the Layers panel. You can see how it looked before this version on the left side of my screen and how it looks now on the right. First, let me reassure you that everything is still here and nothing has been removed. Note that the icons are still here at the top of the Layers panel, though they have been streamlined in the new version. And the layers are all here, but you can now rename them. And the buttons at the bottom of the Layers panel are still there. You'll note that Weld appears to be missing, and in its place, there's a Combine button. If you're watching this video to figure out where Weld went, it's right under the Combine button. But as you'll see, there's so much more there now too, and that's what we're going to talk about. So let's look closer at each change. First, the buttons above the Layers panel. Before we had four buttons, Group, Ungroup, Duplicate, and Delete. Now we have Group and Ungroup merged into one button, and Duplicate and Delete just like before. The labels are no longer underneath the buttons, presumably to make room for something yet to come, which is exciting, but I have no idea what that might be. But if you can't remember which button is which, just hover your mouse over them and the label pops up for you. The Group button will darken when you have two or more layers selected, like this. And when you have a group selected, that button will change to Ungroup. I like this change because there's no need to have two buttons when just one will do. Below these buttons in the Layers panel itself, Cricut has added the feature that we have all been requesting for a long time now, the ability to rename layers. To rename a layer, just double-click on a layer name, and an edit box will appear that you can type right into. When you're done renaming, just press the Enter or Return key on your keyboard, or click somewhere else on the canvas. You can also rename a layer by right-clicking on it with your mouse, or tapping on your trackpad with two fingers to access the drop-down menu, and then just choose Rename at the top. Now, down at the bottom of the Layers panel, we used to have Slice, Weld, Attach, Flatten, and Contour. And these are all the same except the new Combine menu is where Weld used to be. Note that these buttons will all appear grayed out and unclickable until we select at least two layers on the canvas, like these layers in my new cake topper. Now, we can see all the options. If we click once on Combine, we get a menu with the new options. Weld is right there at the top, followed by four new functions: Unite, Subtract, Intersect, and Exclude. These are really special functions that I think you're going to love. Functions like this are included in software like Adobe Illustrator, which I've been using for over 30 years as a designer, and I am super, super excited to see them come to Cricut Design Space. So let's see how each one works. First, rest assured that Weld works exactly as it did before. Whenever you want all selected layers to glue themselves together permanently, just select Weld. Your new layers become a Weld result, which you can see listed in your Layers panel. If you need to undo this, you can immediately click Undo, but otherwise, this is a permanent change. Now let's look at the Unite function under Combine. Use Unite when you want to weld two or more layers together in a less permanent way. That's right. So if I click Unite on my rings now, everything appears to have welded together just like when I used the original Weld command. But there's a difference. Look in the Layers panel and note that my United object here has the original layers nested under it. I can actually click and hide each of those original layers individually. I can even move them. And when I release my mouse, the object appears combined or welded again. And here's the best part. If I click on the combine menu again, I can undo unite and go back to having two unwelded, uncombined layers again. For those of you who've longed for a way to unweld whenever you wanted to, this is the answer. Just use unite instead of weld, and you can undo it anytime you wish, even after you've saved and reopened your project. And it's important to note that if you use Unite, your project will cut out just as you see it on the screen. You do not need to weld it again to get it to cut out as if it were welded. Unite acts just like Weld. It's just repositionable anytime you want during the design process, but it will cut out as if you welded it. So here's a real-world example. This is one of my paper cut lightbox projects. You can add in any image you like to it, like this bride and groom. Select it and one of the layers and click Unite. Now the new image and the layer are one and will cut out united, just like that. But if you don't quite like the position of the couple, you can select just the bride and groom layer and resize it, and it will unite back into the layer. Or select it again and reposition it. You can keep changing it until you like it. So if you've ever put something in a slightly off position, use Unite and you can move it into place without having to undo and repeat your steps. You can see how useful this is going to be, right? Just keep in mind that this is the one instance you might see something on the layers panel, like the two elements used as a unite function, that doesn't match what you see on your canvas. So keep an eye on your layers panel if you use these new tools. I recommend you try using Unite instead of Weld to give you more flexibility in your design work. But what about all those other options? Subtract, intersect, and exclude. Well, subtract is a bit like slice, but again, not permanent. You can also use subtract on two or more layers. While slice only works on two layers and no more than two, which is another useful thing about using the new subtract function. Subtract works by slicing the two bottommost layers, the higher layer from the lower layer. In order for it to work right, you want to be sure your higher layer is not completely covering the bottom layer, as that would just subtract everything if it is. As you can see, subtract looks a lot like slice, except just like unite, the layers you subtracted from one another remain in the layers panel. Again, you can hide, move, and delete those layers to fine-tune your design to your heart's content. Isn't that cool? And if you decide later you don't want your layers combined like this, just go back to the combine menu and undo subtract. Easy peasy. Now, the intersect function clips away the underlying layer almost like a mask. If we use intersect on our two rings, we'll get a brand new shape. The area inside the outline of the new rings is our new shape. We could do this before with slice. It was one of those leftover layers that we usually deleted. But like unite and subtract, our new intersect function keeps the component layers intact and lets us hide, move, and delete the layers independently for fine-tuning our design. And of course, we can undo intersect too. And finally, we have the exclude function, which effectively inverts the layers. If I use it now, it will look like subtract, but if we move one of our layers, you'll see that it's not the same. With exclude, basically the higher layer inverts the lower layer, turning filled regions into holes and vice versa. In other words, it eliminates the overlapping areas and leaves behind the remaining stuff to create a whole new shape. I use exclude the least of all the functions, but it's nice to have it on the rare occasion when you need it. Now, this is a lot of new functions you may or may not need. If you don't need them, just ignore them and keep doing whatever you're doing that's working now for you. But keep them in your back pocket for that special project. And if you do want to use them but feel confused about them, it's no big deal. I've been using these tools for decades in Adobe Illustrator, and I still forget which one to use. So what I do is I just try them all until I like the results. So don't feel funny if that's what you do too, because it works. Now, here are some useful tips. You can use these new functions, unite, subtract, intersect, and exclude, repeatedly on the same layers. So I can unite the two rings, add in a heart, subtract those two layers, duplicate the layer, and then exclude to make this fun new shape. And the layers remain modifiable. Look what happens when I move one of the ring layers. Cool, huh? Do note that after a while, your layers panel may start to get a little complicated, as each time you use one of these new functions, it will need to create new layers to preserve the initial layers that you began with. When you're done modifying things and just want all these layers to go away, you can just go back to the Combine menu and choose Merge Layers. And now you have just one shape. Just be aware that you cannot undo merge layers unless you immediately press the undo button or, of course, undo all the way back to the point at which you merged layers. This is intentional and as it should be, as some people, like myself, will want and need all of those layers produced by the new functions to essentially weld down into one single simple layer. So use it only if you feel confident that you won't want any more changes, you know, to that particular design that you've combined or subtracted or excluded. Something else to keep in mind is that if you ever use slice or weld on layers that aren't merged yet, which you can do, so that's cool, the act of slicing and welding will merge them anyway, and you won't be able to unmerge unless you click undo. So if that's not what you wanted, use one of the other functions instead. And note also that all of these new functions are always available with a right click of your mouse or a double tap on your trackpad. I love this drop-down menu. So if you're not a button clicker, just use this menu instead. And right-clicking on the menu item in the Layers panel will show you the image info for multiple layers, so you always know what you used in a design, even after it's merged, welded, or sliced. Now, it's possible you're watching this and looking at your version of Cricut Design Space, and it just does not match. If you're watching this video soon after it came out, that just means the new version hasn't been rolled out to you yet. The rollout happens over a period of a week or two for a smooth transition. So if you don't see the changes yet, you will eventually. If, on the other hand, it's been a while since I made this video and there's a mismatch, Design Space has probably updated again. I always use the latest version of Cricut Design Space in my tutorials, so head on over to my channel and watch the most recent video about Cricut to learn how the latest version works. And if you're feeling at all frustrated by the changes, I hear you. But I also want to encourage you to take a deep breath and just allow me to teach you and show you how they work. I am here with you every step of the way. I think it's really awesome that Cricut is continuing to develop and improve their software to meet our needs now and in the future. And while that does require that we learn and keep up with the changes, yes, just know that you can always look for my simple videos to get you up to speed fast so you can get right back to making beautiful things with your new skills. And if you're curious about the ring cake topper on my screen here, you can learn all about it over at jennifermaker.com/custom-cake-toppers. I'll be teaching everyone how to make these for free during Maker Academy weekend. Get a ticket to my free weekend event at makeracademy.com/weekend. There are over 20 free workshops on all the latest and greatest projects that you've been asking me how to show you how to make, including these shaker cake toppers, like this anniversary topper and a birthday topper. If you have any questions about these Cricut Design Space changes, please leave a comment below this video and we would be happy to help you. I also want to invite you over to my fabulous Cricut Crafters group at jennifermaker.com/Cricut Crafters. This is a fantastic place to learn about the new features and how to use them in your projects in a welcoming, safe place. And that's it for today. Until next time, this is Jennifer Maker reminding you to craft a life you love.